Hey man, what it is? This is Deem and I am your host and this is By Any Means Necessary. Y'all already know what I'm about to say. I don't care if you leave a dollar, $10, $1,000. It is much, much, much appreciated. Hey you right there, don't be an eavesdropper. You love this cooking, right? You click the video. Can you do something that's free, my guy, and hit that like button? Thank you. Or my girl, whoever it is, or whatever you identify as. It'll be highly appreciated. Everybody that's been showing love in the Cash App, sending super chats, just want to say thank y'all. Without y'all, this channel is nothing. I'll just be talking to myself. So I just want to say thank you. Highly, much, much, much appreciated. But I'm about to say something, y'all, that y'all ain't gonna like, and I don't care because y'all know, damn, I keep receipts. I do this. I be predicting stuff. Maybe I'm a fortune teller. Who knows? So Shakur Stevenson don't got a responsibility, but Jerron Ennis does. Let's talk about it. Lord have mercy. Y'all should have known this was coming. Shakur Stevenson has signed with Eddie Hearn, and he didn't have no fighters over there for him. So now he's taking a guy that's coming from 130 up to 135 that just got knocked out his last fight. Yeah, that's the truth. Jerron Ennis also signed with Eddie Hearn, got his biggest bag of his career, $3.8 million, was headlined in Philadelphia, his hometown. You know, I was ringside. You know, I got to toot my own horn a little bit. I was ringside. Yeah, and then people criticize him and tell him, well, if he wants to fight Bud Crawford, it's his responsibility to go to 154. Ain't nobody at 147. Blase, blase, blah. Basically, y'all, they're putting the onus on Jerron Ennis to make the Terrence Crawford fight, but not Terrence Crawford, even though we all know that that's Terrence Crawford's biggest fight right now at this moment. If you understand, type understand. Never mind, I'm not about to be that petty. But Shakur Stevenson gets to bring up a guy from a lower division. Y'all telling Jerron to go to a higher division, which means that's more difficulty. But Shakur Stevenson get to pick a guy from a lower division, and y'all going to argue for him, the guy that just got knocked out. Please tell me how that makes sense. When Jerron Ennis is much closer to Terrence Crawford, Terrence Crawford last pay-per-view just flopped. Terrence Crawford is not this big star that should get all of this. He demands everything. Jerron Ennis is much closer to Terrence Crawford, monetary-wise, than Shakur Stevenson ever is to Gervonta Davis-wise. Because guess what? Without Terrence Crawford, Jerron Ennis is still a main event in his hometown, selling have 15,000 people in there. Without Gervonta Davis, Shakur Stevenson is getting criticized for his fights and is the co-main. He's not even a main event, nor is he fighting in his hometown. Matter of fact, y'all, he's not even fighting in America. Let's talk about it. Oh, yeah, y'all, Joe Corona. He's switching trainers, too. Somebody made me aware of that, too. This would be his first fight with a different trainer. So, this is me sitting up there just wondering, y'all. This is me sitting up here just wondering, from y'all's standpoint, how can you say Jerron? And then there's the other part. I guarantee whoever Jerron Ennis is fighting next is better than Joe Corona, and that's without a doubt. I bet you whoever Jerron Ennis is fighting next, that's not Terrence Crawford, he's not bringing him up from 140 to fight him. I bet you that. You see what I'm saying? But y'all arguing for Shakur. Well, he's just staying busy, y'all. He getting the bag. Well, guess what, y'all? I can say the same thing. He's not, if Jerron Ennis don't want to move up unless he's getting the Terrence Crawford fight. Actually, a fight that Turki Alikasik said that he would pay for, but hasn't spared at all expenses yet. Just saying. There's only one fighter people been asking Terrence Crawford about, and that is Jerron Ennis. Canelo Alvarez, and they've been asking Canelo about Terrence Crawford. They haven't been asking Terrence Crawford about Canelo because he don't get to decide that. So, it's just mighty funny how Jerron Ennis is doing the same thing that Shakur is doing, but better with the same promoter. But Shakur Stevenson gets a pass and gets told that it's okay when everybody know he didn't have no fighters over there at Matchroom for him at 135. He brings up a guy at a lower weight division. And then y'all say, well, everybody's ducking them, Dean. I agree a lot with that, that a lot of people are ducking them. But you know who everybody else is actually really ducking? You know who's more ducked than Shakur Stevenson? Jerron Ennis. But when I give y'all that excuse, y'all give me another thing that Jerron Ennis should have to do. But Shakur Stevenson don't got to be proactive in making a fight with Gervonta Davis. He could fight a trash man, and we're going to say, well, it's on Tank to make the fight. It's on Terrence Crawford to make the fight, too. Terrence Crawford was mandated and agreed that he would negotiate with Jerron Ennis after that Errol Spence fight. But y'all not going to call that a duck. Terrence Crawford was well aware that he had to negotiate with Jerron Ennis directly after that fight. And he didn't make his mind up yet if he had to go to 154 or none of that. Actually, he tried to make Errol Spence fight him at 147. Actually, he said he'll fight Gervonta Davis at 147. Actually, he dropped his belt for Jerron Ennis, but kept the other three belts for 8 months. That really happened. That actually happened. Well, Dean, he could go to 154. He will. So y'all keep saying that Terrence Crawford is going to get these other belts, right? So when Terrence Crawford gets the IBF belt, then Jerron Ennis could just go up and challenge him for it. You see how that works? Let's see if Terrence Crawford be in a hurry to get that IBF belt. And y'all know the IBF don't play, y'all. So y'all know if Jerron Ennis activates that and goes up to want to challenge Crawford, Crawford will either have to drop the belt or fight the man. And y'all all know that that's true. He already put himself in position to fight Terrence Crawford, become his mandatory. He didn't tell Terrence Crawford to go to one. Terrence Crawford didn't even look better at 154. Terrence Crawford looked like he needs to still be at 147, to be honest. He didn't look as explosive or any of that. All the stuff we thought was going to happen with Crawford, that didn't happen. But Shakur Stevenson get a pass, though. He could fight the trash man, and him being a B-side and wanting a big fight, y'all put all the onus on the A-side fighter. This say that Jerron Ennis got to go up in a weight class, but Shakur get to bring somebody up from a lower weight class and fight him. I guarantee that whoever Jerron Ennis fights next is a better opponent than Joe Corona. I promise you that. And I bet you that Jerron Ennis don't be an undercard either. So if it's okay for Shakur to do it, who is a bigger, I don't even think is a bigger name than Jerron Ennis now, because proof is in the pudding. They both fought in their hometowns, and Jerron Ennis did way better than Shakur Stevenson. But that's a whole nother thing. You can't say it's on the B side to put itself in position to make the A side fighter duck. And when it comes to Jerron Ennis, because you don't want to put the onus on Terrence Crawford, that y'all sit up there and say, well, Jerron got to do X, Y, and Z. And then when I tell you that Shakur Stevenson got to do X, Y, and Z, because he's trying to fight a fighter that is way more popular than Bud Crawford. Bud Crawford would be the B side to the guy that Shakur Stevenson trying to fight. But y'all say it's okay to fight Joe Corona. Okay. The hypocrisy is at its finest. The hypocrisy is at its absolute finest. Flaming hypocrisy. Flaming hypocrisy, and I don't know what else, no other way to sit up there and put that out there like that. Flaming hypocrisy. Y'all been shouting to the nun. And a crate, like I said, I'm going to make this point again. Jerron Ennis is much, much, much closer to Terrence Crawford and monetary gain, popularity, all of that. Basically, what I am saying to you, or Earthmen, is that Jerron Ennis is not as big as a B-side to Terrence Crawford that Shakur Stevenson is to Tank Davis. But y'all say it's Tank's responsibility to make the fight. But it's not Terrence Crawford's responsibility to make the fight. That's like David Benavidez, y'all. I'm not getting the Canelo fight. I'm going to bring somebody up from 160 that just got knocked out. See, just because you're not fighting Tank, that don't mean that you get to fight a trash man. That don't mean that you get to fight a bartender, Joe Corona. That don't mean that you get to fight them. You still have a responsibility to give us the best product possible. You're not even a main attraction. You're a co-main. You're not even a guy that people are paying to watch. We are paying to watch Dmitry Bivol and Beterbiev, and we was going to watch that whether you was on that card or not. And I am a Shakur Stevenson fan. But what I won't do, I got to be a man, though, y'all. You can't run your mouth and be downplaying somebody. And then when you go out there, you don't do the same thing. You're not fighting the best. You're not fighting the best competition. You're not doing the thing that you say that the guy you talking about is not doing. Gervonta Davis is fighting better competition than Shakur Stevenson. Go look at Gervonta's last five fights. Then go look at Shakur Stevenson's last five fights. And it's not even close. Literally, nobody on Shakur Stevenson's resume could beat Ryan Garcia. And I think we all agree on that. But y'all know what this is, though, right? Dean, by any means. They telling me, man, I help y'all get through y'all day. Everybody telling me that, man, I'm one of y'all favorite YouTube channels. If not y'all favorite YouTube channel, I just want to say I do this for y'all. I'm going to continue to be non-biased. I'm going to continue to give it to y'all raw and real. No Diddy, no matter who the fighter is or how much I like him. If Gervonta Davis would have announced Joe Corona, I would have been making a video the same way I'm doing now. So get at me, y'all. Y'all be safe. Holla at your boy.